The complex logarithm is in fact the natural logarithm of a complex number. And I know that some of you are used to having the notation for the natural logarithm to be log, but I'm going to stick with this one, ln, since that is one I'm used to. So what is the natural logarithm of a complex number? We know that a complex number can be written in this form here. It has some real part and some imaginary part. And if you're going to graph it, it will look something like this, right? But this is just one way of representing a complex number. This complex number right now is presented in a rectangular form. But we can also represent a complex number by its length, the absolute value of a complex number, and some angle, which we are going to call alpha. And with some trigonometry, we can write the complex number on the following form. And if we factor out the length of a complex number and use Euler's formula, we get the complex number written in its polar form. And if we use this form instead for our complex number and use some of the laws for a logarithm, the natural logarithm of a complex number becomes the following. And now we can use that the angle is the argument for the complex number. And here it is important to remember that this argument can be many different values, since there are an infinite number of angles that corresponds to the same complex number. I mean, if you have an angle and you add or subtract 2 pi, you will still end up on the exact same spot in the complex plane. And that is why we need to define a new kind of argument for complex numbers. This new argument is called the principal argument and is denoted the same way as before, but this time with a capital A at the start. And its formal definition is that the principal argument is the angle for the complex number that lies between minus pi and pi, and can therefore only have one value. So in short, the principal argument is just one number, just one angle for a complex number, while the argument of a complex number is all possible angles. And the relationship between these two is that the argument for a complex number is equal to the principal argument plus n times 2 pi for some n. And by using this new knowledge, the whole formula for a natural logarithm of a complex number becomes the following. This formula is also called the multivalued logarithm, since it takes on many different values for the same complex number. But sometimes we are just looking for one value, the principal value, which is denoted by ln with a capital L. And this principal value of a logarithm is when n is equal to 0 in the multivariable formula. And one important thing to remember about these two formulas is that they only work if the complex number is not equal to 0, since the natural logarithm is not defined for 0. Let's continue by doing an example. Here I want us to determine the multivalued logarithm of a complex number 1 plus I, and also its principal value. To solve this problem, we need to know two things. We need to know the absolute value of a complex number, and we need to know its principal argument. And we can determine these two from this figure. By using the Pythagorean theorem, we know that the absolute value of this complex number is equal to the square root of 2. And by using the arctangent function, we know that the principal argument is equal to pi divided by 4. And now the only thing that is left is to plug in the values into the formulas. So the multivalued logarithm will become the following. And the principal value is just the multivalue with n is equal to 0. So that one becomes the following. Thanks for watching.